Hello, my name is Moshoa, and in this video I'll be showing you how to download PC-lint Plus and add it to your environment path. My hope is that by the end of the video you'd have the ability to run PC-lint Plus from any directory, which takes away some of that friction when you're getting started. There are timestamps in the description that highlight the three operating systems. You can follow the section of the video that is relevant to you. So let's get started. To follow along, simply download PC-lint Plus for your operating system. Here's the download page. The link is also available in the description. From this page, you will select the operating system that's relevant to you, if that's Linux, macOS, or Windows. Make sure that you fill out the evaluation form found here. Once you have filled out the evaluation form, you'll receive an email containing the license file with the .lic extension. This file is required to run PC-lint Plus. Here's the result of the download. Once the download is complete, you can extract the file or unzip if you are on Windows or Mac. Once the file is extracted, you're able to move the license file that you received in your email to where the executable is located. Keep in mind that the executable has a different name per operating system, so that will be PCLP64_macOS for Mac and PCLP64.exe for Windows. Now that we have the download completed, let's add PC-lint Plus to the path environment on Linux. We'll start with setting up the path environment for a bash shell. Make note of the directory where the executable is located because we're going to need that at a later step. Open up a shell window. The first command we'll run is cd. The second command will be echo, single quote, export path is equal to $ path, semicolon, and then the directory where the executable is located. So for me, that is /home/desktop/pclp.linux_.2.0/pclp, single quote, > .bashrc, click enter, click the up arrow, remove the .bashrc and type in profile, click enter. And now we can close this shell window and open up a new one. And we will verify the changes with the command echo $path. And as you can see, the executable path is listed. And now we will run PC-lint Plus to verify PCLP64_Linux with the minus version option. And here you can see the version, which is the expected behavior. Note that we only added PC-lint Plus to the user path and not the system path. To do the system path, you would have to cd into etc instead and change the relevant profile and bashrc files there. This concludes the Linux section. Let's get started on Mac. Press command space, type in terminal, open up a new terminal window, and now we will go to where the executable is located, and we will do that using the command cd. We'll open up the folder where the executable is located so we can copy the path. Right-click on the folder, hold the Option key, copy PCLP as path name. We'll go back to the terminal window, Command-V, click Return. And now we have to make sure that PC-lint Plus is treated as an executable on Mac, and we will type in the command chmod space plus x space /PCLP64_macOS. And now that the executable is treated correctly, we can go ahead and type in the command sudo nano /etc/paths, type in the password. And now we can go all the way to the bottom and command V, control X, Y, click return. And now we can go ahead and close out of this terminal window, open up a new one, and we can call the executable to try it out, PCLP64_macOS with a minus version option. This is the expected output, and now we can see the version number. This concludes our section for Mac. Let's get started on Windows. We'll start off by pressing the Window key and R, and then we'll be able to type in sysdm.cpl and hit OK. Then you'll be asked to enter your password, so go ahead and do that. Keep in mind that you might need admin access in order to do this. Once the System Properties menu is open, we can go ahead and click on the Advanced tab, Environment Variables. We'll find the path in the System Variables. Click on Edit, New, Browse. And here you can specify the folder containing the PC-lint Plus executable. In my case, it's PCLP. Go ahead and hit OK. And here you'll be able to see that the folder was added successfully. Press OK. Press OK. Press OK one last time. We'll go ahead and open up a command prompt. Type in the command echo %sign path %sign. And we'll be able to see that the folder where PC-lint Plus executable is located is actually listed. And we can also try PCLP64 with the minus version option. This is the expected output as it shows the version that I'm on. This concludes the Windows section. I hope you have found this video to be helpful. The next step in using PC-lint Plus would be to create a compiler configuration for your compiler. We have a few videos on this topic, and it's documented in section 2.3 of the reference manual. If you're running into any issues or have video topic suggestions, feel free to reach out to us on support@pcintplus.com. Have a good one.